Hello YouTube modelers, John D here in the 40 watt garage. This is part one of my Milner's 32 Ford 5 window coupe build. In a previous video I detailed the build of a 58 Impala, and this is car number two of my American Graffiti trilogy. I settled on the Ravel 2-in-1 kit for several reasons. It was a 2-in-1. It has lots of extra parts for my scrap box. It has full fenders, which I will need later on to do the body. It's got a multi-piece hood. I don't have to cut and section anything. It has the steel wheels along with mags for the scrap box. And it's not ridiculously priced like the now hard to find American Graffiti pre-box kits or the die casts by Ravel, MPC, or AMT. And I can make the modifications and details myself, and they'd be true to the prototype real car. On any tribute project like this, I start out by doing a lot of internet research, finding good photographs of the original car for reference. If there's not a photo of a particular detail, then I'll use some artistic license. So with that, let's get started on the engine. The intake manifold was a scrap box piece from an old tea bucket kit that I had, and it was originally a 6x2 setup. But the spacing was right, so I just milled off the center two carburetors. Made some throttle linkage and fuel fittings from brass stock, soldered it together, drilled the carbs, and put the linkages in place. That was some no caffeine work again. And a few more detail shots of this work. Drilled the distributor cap, inserted the plug wires, and made some fuel tubing from some wire insulation. Here's a shot of the original engine in the real car. Some firewall detail. And back to my intake carbs and distributor. I'm not going to bore you with shots of the glue up and paint and things like that. I think you guys probably know how to do that stuff. And I jump way ahead to a practically finished engine. I get into the zone on the bench and I just forget to take photographs, so partly my fault. So this is the engine in its almost finished state. You can see that there's holes drilled for plugs and then also locating pins for the headers. And that's about where it sits with the engine right now. One of the things I've never liked about model kits is that molded, clunky crank water pump alternator pulley thing that they have on the kits. So I machined my own from aluminum rod stock on a Sherline miniature lathe, and then I make my own V-belts from black silicone. I'll be detailing how to do that in a future video. And the oil filler tube is also a piece machined from aluminum rod stock, and then I used some Detail Master alternator brackets. The exhaust headers were also from the T-Bucket kit. I used them because they reached out far enough from the engine block to clear the bodywork and then transition down. Fortunately, they had dumps on them, whereas the real car here you can see has collector transitions to a muffler system tucked under the car. So I machined some new collectors from aluminum rod stock, tapered it down, used a piece of tubing to link the aluminum piece to the plastic header, which was sectioned off, and that's what it looks like when they are put together. And then I can transition with exhaust pipe under the frame and then up to the mufflers. Here's where those locating holes and pins came into play. There's pins in the ends of the header tubes, and then they fit into the holes that were drilled into the engine block to locate them exactly in the right place. Well, that does it for part one of the 32.5 window Milner's coupe. I hope you enjoyed the pictures. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for part two, where we will detail some of the chassis modifications.